Hey guys, this week's video is all about chlamydia, a very common sexually transmitted infection. We're going to talk about chlamydia symptoms, we're going to talk about chlamydia treatment, and we're going to talk about chlamydia and what complications it can cause if it's not treated. So please, please, please watch the entire video because it's going to give you loads and loads of information. So welcome to my channel. If you haven't been here before, we talk about everything medical and healthcare related. Also, in the description below, the entire video is chaptered. So if you want to find any specific information, feel free to click on it and click on the piece of information you want to find. However, as I always say, please watch the entire video, especially with this video. It's super important you watch everything in the video just so you become a bit of a chlamydia pro, so you know everything about the condition or the disease. Also, please don't forget to click the like button. If you find anything useful in this video, don't forget to click that like button. It's going to help me, it's going to help the video, it's going to help the video become viewable to more people around the world so it can help them as well. Let's begin. So without further ado, let's jump straight into it. So chlamydia, it is one of the most common sexually transmitted infections. We're going to call it STI for short from now on. In the UK, okay? It is passed on through unprotected sex, but you can also pass it on through infected semen and infected vaginal fluid, so please do bear that in mind. Now, you can also get infected with chlamydia through genital contact, even if there is no penetration. So bear in mind why it's so important that we say that barrier methods are used, such as condoms, to prevent the spread of STIs. Now, it may also surprise you that infected sex toys that haven't been washed or cleaned can also spread chlamydia. Also, please remember that the infected fluids, like I said, from the infected semen or the infected vaginal fluids, if this gets into the eye, it can also cause chlamydia. It can cause you to catch chlamydia. Also, please bear in mind that if you do have chlamydia and you do give birth to a baby, most likely the baby will have chlamydia as well. Now, the good news is that chlamydia cannot be passed on through kissing, through hugging, through sharing cutlery, going to a swimming pool, or even sitting on a toilet seat. Okay, so now let's go through chlamydia symptoms, but before we go through all of that, I need to tell you something really important about chlamydia. 70% of women are what we call asymptomatic, so that means they have no symptoms to show they have chlamydia, and 50% of men are asymptomatic, so they have no symptoms to show that they have chlamydia. This is one of the reasons why chlamydia is one of the most common STIs here in the UK, and also it's again one of the reasons why it's so important that you're using a condom and also you are getting an STI test regularly, but we're going to go into all of that a bit later on. So please remember, if you're just looking for symptoms in this video to think, do I have the symptoms, it doesn't work like that because such a large number of people are asymptomatic. So in terms of symptoms, the most common symptoms are one, pain during urination. This is probably one of the most common symptoms, and also any discharge. This can be either from the vagina, the penis, or the bottom, and also any itchiness in or around the bottom area. Now, a few symptoms that are seen in women include abdominal pain, also bleeding after sex or bleeding in between your periods, and lastly, having heavier periods than you usually would. Now, in men, a few common symptoms again, obviously the pain during urination, that's one of the most common symptoms, but also some men find that there's swelling in their testicles or pain in their testicles. Now, in terms of testing, it really depends on your locality here in the UK. There are different STI clinics available in different regions of the UK and they all offer different things. So I'll leave links in the description below on where you can find out more information about this. The majority of STI clinics here in the UK can send out postal testing kits for you to do a test at home and then you post it back to them. There's also the National Chlamydia Screening Program as well, which is being run. This is mainly for women under the age of 25, but again, I'm going to leave loads more information about testing in the description below. So in short, there's basically the free STI clinic test, but there are also ones that you can buy over the counter from a chemist or online. Again, I'm going to leave loads of information in the description below for you. And in terms of the test, it's very easy. So for men and women, they can both sort of do a urine test. This is a very easy one. For men particularly, this is the only test that they'll do. And for women, it can either be a urine test or it might be a swab done inside the vagina and also in the anus, in that sort of region, just to test for chlamydia. So that's how the test is done. It's very easy, it's very painless, and also it can get a result very quickly and accurately. Now, the next question is, how often should you be getting a chlamydia test? Well, it's recommended that you get one at least every year, especially if you're under the age of 25. However, there's no harm in getting it if you're older than 25. Also, each time you change your sexual partner, again, that's a real good reason to get your chlamydia test done and STI tests done. And also, if you're having a lot of sex without a condom on, again, it's another reason to get yourself tested. So don't just go off the once a year that I've just mentioned, but really think about it, how often you're having sex with new partners, or also how often you're having unprotected sex, as these put you at a much higher risk. Okay, so far we spoke about chlamydia, we spoke about chlamydia symptoms, and we spoke about how it's spread and everything we need to know about it so far, including testing as well. So what about treatment? Well, if you are someone who tests positive for chlamydia, the treatment is very easy and it's a short course of antibiotics. However, please do remember, always let your healthcare professional know about any allergies that you have, as this is really important, as certain antibiotics people are allergic to. And secondly, let them know about any medication that you are taking as well, because antibiotics can interact with a lot of medicines as well. And as with all medication, it's always really important to let your healthcare professional know if you are pregnant. Again, some antibiotics are safe in pregnancy and some are not. So if you think you might be pregnant again, please let your healthcare professional know, as your safety is the most important thing. Now, if you do have a positive test, the sexual health clinic will speak to you about other people that you've had sexual intercourse with as well, and letting them know that you've tested positive and they need to get a test done and potentially get treated for it. However, if you're uncomfortable about contacting these people as well, the sexual health clinics can help with this and contact those individuals confidentially without letting them know who it's come from. So if you're worried about that at all, speak to them about it, because they are able to help a lot with this. Now, if there is a strong possibility that you could have chlamydia, so for example, if a sexual partner has been tested positive for chlamydia, and as well, you might have symptoms as well, then your healthcare professional might decide to actually treat you with antibiotics before a test is actually done. Again, this is down to their discretion, but I just thought I'd make you aware of this as well. This does happen now and then as well. And one final really important thing about treatment, it's really important that when you have your antibiotics to treat the chlamydia, if you are tested positive, that you do not have sexual intercourse for at least 7 days until the treatment is done. Now, the treatment isn't going to be a 7-day course, but the reason you need to not have sex for 7 days after taking your antibiotic is to give it time to get rid of the chlamydia, so you're less likely to actually spread the chlamydia once you have sex again. Now, the next thing I want to discuss with you is the complications associated with chlamydia, especially when it's untreated. There are complications with chlamydia, and that's one of the reasons why it's so important that it's treated early, okay? Let's talk about the complications. Now, in terms of complications, one, if chlamydia is left untreated, both men and women can have fertility issues. This is, again, one of the reasons why it's so important we test for chlamydia and treat it, okay, because it's going to potentially cause fertility issues. Secondly, chlamydia can cause something called reactive arthritis. I'm going to say that again because I don't think I pronounced it right. Reactive arthritis. This is where we get inflammation and pain in our joints, okay? Third of all, if you're pregnant and you have chlamydia, it can put you at higher complication risks during pregnancy, one of which is premature birth, so giving birth early before the due date. And lastly, if you do have chlamydia and you're pregnant when you give birth to your child, there's a very high risk that it could have chlamydia, and this could also put them at higher risk of eye infections and chest infections, and they will be tested for chlamydia, of course, as well. So in terms of when to seek medical advice, remember, if you have any symptoms of chlamydia, you need to seek medical advice. If you're just watching this video because you're thinking of getting tested, then get tested. Speak to your local STI clinic, speak to your healthcare professional. I'm going to leave loads of information in the description below as well. But please remember as well, if you feel like you've taken the antibiotics and you're still having symptoms, or if you didn't wait before the 7 days, like I said, before having sex again, or if you feel like you still have it for any reason, speak to your healthcare professional. This is very important. Also, if you're pregnant, this is even more of a reason to speak to your healthcare professional. So I hope this provides some clarity. I really hope that you find this information helpful. You now know everything you need to know about chlamydia, chlamydia symptoms, chlamydia treatment, and everything else about it. So I really hope that you found this information helpful. As I always say at the end of every single video, always remember you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Also, I can't remember what I was going to say next, so I'm going to have to read here. Now, a few symptoms that we see in women. Also, another thing as well is that I can't remember what the other thing is, so I'm going to have to... Okay. All your periods. Yeah. Okay. 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 Okay, so now that we've done, okay. Okay, so now that we spoke about the symptoms of chlamydia, okay. Now in terms of complications, now. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.